Hello, child. Shall we continue your lessons?
Hey again, YouTube. Back with another Vita retro gaming video. This time it's how to get the PC version of Baldur's Gate running on the PlayStation Vita using Northfear's port of GemRB. GemRB is an open source implementation of the Infinity Engine behind Planescape Torment and the Baldur's Gate and Icewind Dale games. With this port, you'll be able to run all 8 Infinity Engine-based games, along with a lot of the community-made mods and tweaks. In this video, we're going to go over installing the GemRB port, installing, updating, and tweaking Baldur's Gate on the PC, and then I'm going to show you just how well this thing runs on the Vita. So let's get started. For browsing and installing Vita Homebrew, I like to use the EasyVPK app, but it's always a good idea to check the release page for whatever you're installing. A lot of Vita Homebrew requires additional plugins, tweaks, or data files to be transferred to work. The Vita port of GemRB can be found over at Northfear's GitHub page, and I'll put a link to it below. Pulling it up, we can see that GemRB needs either the Repatch Redux 0 plugin or the FTFix plugin for proper suspend and resume support. I tried running it without FTFix, and it just crashed as soon as the screen turned off. The GitHub page also gives a good overview of the scrolling text input system, as well as the pre-map button scheme. I haven't poured too many hours into Baldur's Gate or Planescape yet, but the map controls feel complete. The releases link is where you'll find the pre-compiled VPK and data files if you're not using a homebrew installer like EasyVPK. Download the data files and then install the VPK with Vita Shell or something similar. Be sure to transfer the data files to the proper GemRB directory. So back on our Vita, GemRB is done installing and extracting the data files. If you're using a homebrew installer, be patient because the extraction could take about 5 or 10 minutes. I'm installing Baldur's Gate using my backup images, but follow the same steps if you're using CDs. Do a complete install by selecting all the data files in the installer. After installing, we're going to copy even more files from the CDs, so you'll need about 3 gigs free on your Vita memory card. My version of Baldur's Gate is already updated, but if yours isn't, be sure to patch it to the current version right after installing. Tweaks for the Infinity Engine games can be found over at the Gibberlings 3. Here you can find the Baldur's Gate 2 and Icewind Dale fix packs, but what we're looking for is the Tweaks Anthology, a complete rollup for all the Infinity Engine games. So back on the PC, Baldur's Gate is finished installing. Each CD has a directory named CD1 through CD5. We're going to copy that directory from each disk to the Baldur's Gate installation directory. Next, I'm going to make a backup of the Baldur's Gate installation directory just in case something goes wrong with the Tweaks installation. The final step on the PC is installing the Tweaks Anthology from the Gibberlings 3. This is a massive package of tweaks, many of which will only make sense to expert players of these games. You'll definitely want to pull up the README for the Tweaks pack before installing, or you can end up with a really unbalanced game. Now plug in your Vita and get it into file transfer mode in whatever method you normally use. And we're going to copy the Baldur's Gate installation folder from the PC to the GemRB folder on the Vita. This is going to take a while, so when the files are transferring, we're going to take a look at the Baldur's Gate configuration file named bg1.cfg. In my case, I didn't need to change anything in the configuration file, but if you've installed the widescreen mod for any of the Infinity Engine games, this is where you change your resolution. After making any changes to the configuration file and confirming everything is correct, all that's left to do is wait for the files to finish copying. I have time-lapse magic. You'll wish you did. Alright, that's enough for me for now. Let's go take a look at how this thing runs on the Vita. The intro video played smoothly, but you'll probably get a little delay when starting a new game. You may want to dial down the music since it's a little high and tends to drown out everything else, and increase the mouse scroll rate since it might be a little slow for your liking by default.
Nestled atop the cliffs that rise from the Sword Coast, the Citadel of Candlekeep houses the finest and most comprehensive collection of writings on the face of Farron. It is an imposing fortress, kept in strict isolation from the intrigues that occasionally...
I tried to get the frame rate to display using a plugin called Lolicon, but all I got was a little green blob in the corner. You won't see that on your copy of the game, though. I'm only a couple hours into Baldur's Gate and Planescape Torment on the Vita with this GemRB port, but so far it's been great with no crashes or unexpected game-breaking bugs. This is a really impressive port, and definitely one worth checking out if you've ever wanted to play any of the BioWare Infinity Engine games and were putting it off like I was. If you're interested in getting Planescape Torment running on the Vita, I'll link to my other video below, but for now, thanks for watching.